Hello dear students, welcome back to physics online session. So in last class we are in the discussion of magnetic field in case of current carrying coil. So after that, so already we come to know that what are the neat applications related to, so that's a current carrying coil. So if that current carrying coil is present, certain amount of current is flowing in that coil, I want to find that what is the magnetic field at the center of the coil. So if the coil is semicircle, what is the magnetic field at the center of that coil? So if that 3/4 of the circle you can consider, then what will be its magnetic field? All such aspect already we learnt in previous videos. Now in this session we will be discussing another important law related to that moving charges, that is whatever that Biot-Savart law is there. So extended form of Biot-Savart law we can consider. So as we discuss in case of electric charge and field, we consider Gauss law. That Gauss law is alternate form of Coulomb's law. So whatever the Gauss law in electrostatics is there, that Gauss law in electrostatic is alternate form of Coulomb's law. In the similar way, I will consider here Ampere circuit law. What's that law here? Ampere circuit law. So that Ampere circuit law will give that relation between current and magnetic field. Did you get my point? Ampere circuit law will give that relation between current and magnetic field. This Ampere circuit law is alternate form of Biot-Savart law. Already we come to know about that Biot-Savart law. So D of B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi Idl sin theta divided by R square. So that Biot-Savart law also gives that relation between current and magnetic field. Now in case of Ampere circuit law also, it gives that relation between current and magnetic field. This Ampere circuit law is alternate form of Biot-Savart law. So in today's session we will be discussing about that Ampere circuit law. Ampere circuit law we can consider here. So this Ampere circuit law will give that information. It states that line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface is equal to mu naught times of total current enclosed by it. So look at here. This is one closed circuit or closed path you can consider, right? Whatever the magnetic field is there, the line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface is equal to mu naught times of total current enclosed by it. I will write the statement related to Ampere circuit law. It states that the line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface is equal to mu naught times of total current enclosed by it. So what's the mathematical formula related to this Ampere circuit law? I said that line integral of magnetic field, I can take integration sign here. Line integral means line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface. So this indicates that closed surface here. Line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface is equal to mu naught times of total current enclosed by it. So integration of B into D of L. So which is equal to mu naught times of total current enclosed by it. Look at here. What's the statement here? Line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface is equal to mu naught times of total current enclosed by it. Or we can write this equation by another way. B into D of L cos theta, which is equal to mu naught into I. So this is the required expression for Ampere circuit law. For example, I said that line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface is equal to mu naught times of total current enclosed by it. So in this closed path, suppose this is current I1, right? So this is current I2, again this is current I3, again this is current I4. Then how will you take the total current here? I said that in that last class only we discussed that here cross mark indicates that field lines are inward direction or current is inward direction, where dot indicates that current is outward direction. Look at here, cross mark indicates that current is entering, so into the plane. Dot indicates that current is entering out of the plane, we can consider. Then how will you take the total current here? So in this case I will take the total current as B into D of L, which is equal to mu naught into, if the current is entering towards the plane, that current is positive, out of the plane, that is negative, I1 minus of I2 plus of I3 minus of I4. Remember here, so if it is enter into the plane, that is positive, if it is moving out of the plane, so that current is negative, we can consider here. So hope you understand about these ampere circuit alla. Related to these ampere circuit alla, we are having lot of applications on that ampere circuit alla. Let me consider what are the applications related to ampere circuit. By taking use of that ampere circuit alla, we will derive that expression for, derive an expression for magnetic field due to infinite long straight current carrying conductor. It means that I will take one conductor, that conductor having that infinite length. In that infinite length of that conductor, certain amount of current is flowing. So if that length of the conductor is infinite, then what will be the magnetic field? Magnetic field is finite or infinite, I can consider. Look at here, I consider one infinite long straight current carrying conductor. I will take that infinite conductor here, means infinite length of the conductor I can consider here. In that infinite length of that conductor, certain amount of current is flowing. So whenever the current is flowing around the current carrying conductor, magnetic field is present, right? The length of the conductor is infinite, then what about the magnetic field? You will get finite magnetic field or infinite magnetic field I can consider. Look at here, I will consider infinite straight wire here. Look at here, I will take that infinite straight wire. For example, XY is one conductor that is having infinite length. In this conductor, certain amount of current is flowing. Whenever the current is flowing in case of conductor, around the current carrying conductor, magnetic field is present, right? So from that thumb rule, right hand thumb rule, we can consider. So what that right hand thumb rule here? So from the right hand thumb rule, we can consider the direction of the current and magnetic field here. So for example, in order to get the direction of the magnetic field, so I said that current is flowing in a forward direction. So I will hold the conductor in a right hand. Thumb indicates the direction of the current, whereas folded finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field, right? I will take one point of observation here. Let P be the point of observation where the magnetic field is to be determined. So I want to find that value of magnetic field at point P here. This point P is at a distance of R from the wire. From the wire, at what distance the point of observation is present here? So from that wire, at a distance of R, point of observation is present. Like, so in this situation, whatever the magnetic field is there, that magnetic field is uniform along its circumference. Okay, so here this is the direction of the current, means this is the direction of the magnetic field. Now I will take small length element at this point here. I will take one small length element here, right? I will draw on that tangent line for this length element. I will draw on tangent line. D of L is the length element I can consider. Then I want to find the direction of the magnetic field. So what is the direction of the magnetic field? I have to draw a tangent line to that point. So that point will give the direction of the magnetic field. Look at here. I want to find the direction of magnetic field at point P. So at point P, I will draw one tangent line here. Look at here. This is the tangent line. What it means here? Length element and magnetic field both are in the same direction. Did you get my point? Look at here. I consider one straight wire. In that straight wire, certain amount of current is flowing. Because of that current, you will get magnetic field at point P here. So I will take circumference here. Right. So this is the direction of the magnetic field. Magnetic field is in this way. I want to consider one small length element here. At point P, I want to find that magnetic field. Means at point P, I will choose one small length element. For that length element, I will draw a tangent line. And at this point, I want to find the direction of the magnetic field. In order to get the direction of magnetic field at point P, I have to draw a tangent line at point P. Did you get my point? I want to find the direction of magnetic field at point P. So at point P, what is the direction of magnetic field? So this is the direction of the magnetic field and this is the direction of length element. It means that length element and magnetic field both are in the same direction. Then what is the angle here? Angle is 0 degree, I can consider. Okay. So write some descriptive part about the diagram. Consider an infinite straight wire. Infinite straight wire is XY having current I here. So in this infinite straight conductor, so certain amount of current is flowing. Let P be the point of observation. Let P be the point of observation at a distance r from the wire. That point of observation is at a distance r from the wire, where magnetic field is to be determined. In this point, I want to find that magnetic field, where magnetic field is to be determined. Right. So from Ampere circuit law. From Ampere's circuit law. Okay, I will write it here. So from Ampere circuit law, line integral of magnetic field around any closed surface is equal to mu naught times of total current. Or I can rewrite this equation, B into D of L cos theta, which is equal to mu naught into I. What is the angle between magnetic field and length element? So both are in the same direction, means theta value is 0 degree. So what's that theta value here? Theta value is 0. Then look at here. B into D of L is equal to mu naught into I, where I can apply that integration to the top length element DL. Integration of D of L is equal to L, where L I can consider that circumference of this circle. Wherever you can find that magnetic field, you will get the same answer here. Look at here, B into. So integration of D of L is L. So length is equal to circumference of this circle. So I can consider integration of D of L is equal to 2 pi r. Integration of D of L is L, where L is equal to circumference of this circle. Just I can take it as 2 pi r, which is equal to mu naught into I. I want to find the value of magnetic field at this point, right? B is represent value of magnetic field. That B is equal to mu naught into I divided by 2 pi r here. This is the required expression for magnetic field due to infinite long straight current carrying conductor. B represents magnetic field strength, whereas mu naught represents that permeability I can consider. I represents that amount of current here. R represents that radius of the circular path.